All right.
But Ringo was nowhere to be found.
Ringo. Damn it, he escapes my grasp once again.
I knew you didn't kill Ringo, because he was found dead in a different location altogether.
To this day, his killer is still unknown.
Indeed. Took me a few months before I finally tracked his ass to West Turkey Creek Canyon.
That's cool. That was weird that the mission keeps going. Oh, I see. John and Ringo, that's one hell of a Fu Manchu.
That's incredible, sir. I always thought that Doc Holliday was the one that killed him.
Speed was
That's
perfect
incredible,
too,
sir. I always thought that Doc Holliday was the one that killed him.
Oh! That tree lost the duel. Fucking tree.
That's incredible, sir. I always thought that Doc Holliday was the one that killed him.
Sorry
take it.
I had to ruin the legend for you, boy.
I'll take it.
But the legend ain't always true. Doc Holliday had nothing to do with the death of Johnny Ringo.
That tree. I got the tree and I got Johnny.
I was paid a healthy bounty for Ringo and Curly Bill and realized there was real money to be made. That's why I went after Henry Plummer.
The innocence.
Now, wasn't he the sheriff who augmented his income by shaking down miners and robbing gold shipments?
That's the one.
Oh, yeah, I remember him. He ran that gang of thieving outlaws called the innocence.
So it's true that you went toe-to-toe with him?
Indeed I did, son. Indeed I did.
That started me on a bloody career as a bounty hunter. Whoa, this looks like... So we going down a mine?
I knew I needed resources if I was going to track down Roscoe Bob Bryant. And hunting Plummer looked like a good way to get rich quick. As the local vigilantes exposed him as the leader of the bandits and put a generous price on his head. Plummer rallied his gang to plunder one last gold mine before making their escape. And that's where I thought I'd find him.
It makes me nervous standing so close to all these goddamn barrels of gunpowder.
Why would you be nervous? No one has the cojones to come after us. As long as you don't light up a cigar, we're fine.
Yeah, besides, George is up there on the rocks with that rifle of his. Nothing gets past him.
Why can't I get a clear shot on the explosives?
my late father pointed out to me more than once, God made men, and Samuel Colt made them equal.
Where's the guy out with the rifle? Oh, there we go, engraved ranger. Yeah. Nice. I don't know what the hell I'm doing. Just following the path that is in front of me. Oh, this is where the guy on the hill is supposed to be. Well, all right. All right, that was for nothing. Got some ammo. What? I'm like out on the other side of the hill. Oh, that wasn't the mine entrance, huh? My bad. Still got a ways to go. That would be too easy.
I knew that dynamite wasn't mine, so I decided the polite thing would be to return it. It was the biggest gold rush since Sutter's Mill in 40 years. Unfortunately, prospectors weren't the only ones drawn to those riches.
Oh, shit.
There were thieves and killers, robbing travelers and hijacking gold shippers. Like those that ran with Plummer. Some were just regular folks I knew from town, drawn by greed and easy pickings. Charlie Crow, blacksmith.
Oh, shit.
James, who worked in the stable.
I'm putting you down.
Sam and Jeremiah Barber, the butcher's son. Ordinary citizens who lived a double life.
They were ordinary.
And murdering their neighbors. Of course, the rest were veterans of the Civil War. Stone cold killers trained on the bloody fields of Shiloh, Antietam. Plummer had a lot of men on his payroll. A hell of a lot. That son of a bitch pretended to protect the public with one hand, while stealing them blind with the other. He set up a defensive perimeter which I had no idea how to breach. If Daddy had lived to see Alfred Nobel's explosive invention, my guess is he would have told Samuel Colt to kiss his ass. Dangerous, desperate individual. I was outnumbered and in way over my head, but I was too damn stubborn and stupid to realize.
Ah, we're good.
They must have thought I was tough. Or had some kind of death wish. Seeing as there were barrels of gunpowder everywhere.
Look at that, the jumping.
Watch out for the goddamn gunpowder!
What's that?
One stray bullet, one stray spark, and I'd be blown to hell and gone. Did I have any second thoughts about what I was doing? No. Okay,
there's a weapon flashing somewhere.
Do I thought I was some kind of hero.
I'm not.
I finally made it past and headed on to meet my destiny.
I would hide a secret in there, but no, there's nothing in there.
But first, I had something I needed to figure out.
What? First, I need to figure something out. What do I need to figure out?
I had a few ideas on how to get into that mine, but once I made my decision, I knew there was no turning back. So my first thought was to enter the nearest mine portal. I saw an entrance. Made sense. It was the quickest way in, but that also made it more dangerous, as there would undoubtedly be enemy pickets posted along the way.
Just like, argh, the Terminator. Zero fucks were given. Shotgun. Shotgun might actually be better here.
Besides, once you enter a mine like that, it's easy to get all turned around. And that confusing maze of corridors wouldn't even be the worst of it. Some of those shafts could be as deep as hell. Single stumble or misstep can easily end in a deadly plunge to oblivion.
I'm here!
I guess.
Quick reflexes often make up for a lack of common sense. Luckily, I was never one to be easily bushwhacked. I would just need to be careful not to blow myself to kingdom come.
Damn, these guys are hitting harder and harder.
With all that gunpowder and dynamite everywhere, a body has to know what he's shooting.
Oh,
all it takes
shit.
Is one tiny spark, and boom.
Oh, my God. I thought I was going to be sweet. Missed the whole door.
You're not out of bullets. You ain't beefing me.
One wrong bullet could have turned that mine into a dad blasted tomb.
What the hell? Oh shit! What in the hell is happening? Like, this means I need to run like hell.
I freely admit okay. My plan of attack is not just moronic, but clearly insane.
Whoa.
It's a good thing that I abandoned that ridiculous plan before I even tried it.
Oh.
Instead, I spotted a ladder way into the mine.
All right,
from the
that's
opposite
awesome.
Side.
What ladder? Ah.
It was a long way around, but that approach seemed more sensible at the time.
Holy shit.
Of course, being I had a problem with heights, that scaffolding scared the bejesus out of me. Climbing down that ladder required some caution. Because even though I had a younger man's reflexes, no man can dodge a damn bullet while climbing down a rickety ladder.
I'm supposed to jump that?
I needed to make a leap of faith. Which ain't easy when you're suspended between heaven and hell. I was determined not to give up, however.
Oh, shit.
As Sheriff Plummer seemed quite the despicable character. When the vigilantes discovered what the sheriff was up to, people were outraged. That 10,000 they put on his head would go a long way to helping me find old Bob. And I had made it my mission to settle that score come hell or high water.
Yep.
But first, I would have to make a choice.
Oh?
Take the elevator or climb the ladder.
Let's climb the ladder. Nah, fuck it, let's take the elevator.
I picked the more convenient and more dangerous route.
You know this guy?
Plummer was a mad dog killer, and the people of Nevada City deserved better.
Nevada City? Well, I thought Plummer met his maker in Bannock, Montana.
A little bit too late on that one. What the...
Right, well, he was the sheriff of both places at one time or another, but that's neither here nor there. The point was, taking him down would save a lot of lives, including my own.
Yeah, the guy that's, the main character's telling the story to the bar, so that's why it kind of keeps changing and shit. Henry Plummer. He's a scallywag.
Ooh! Well, this day is getting worse and worse for you.
Henry Plummer was clearly unhinged, and I could see right away that this was going to take some time.
That guy was on the other side. I wanted him to go to that side too. That was just, that was dumb. I should just use my six shooter. Where's that asshole again?
This is gonna hurt! What do you think you're doing? I'm going all medieval on your ass!
I need to keep track of the fucking stupid guys, and since they like start me in the middle of this, I actually can't. It's fucking annoying as shit.
Thank you.
God! Jesus fucking Christ.
That's how Henry Plummer died. Him and his crew were worth their weight in gold. And now, I was officially a bounty hunter.
Arr! Officially. All right. That was a good little session there.